To get started, let's take a quick look at our hotel model. It was created in MicroStation, but could just as easily have been done in other design programs like Autodesk's Revit or Trimble's SketchUp. But we're Bentley, so, of course, MicroStation. You'll notice that this building already includes textures and features usually associated with the image or animation rendering operations. To launch LuminarT, we navigate to the Visualization ribbon in MicroStation Connect Edition, and click the LuminarT icon. As you can see, our hotel is now sitting in the middle of a very large open area surrounded by mountains. This is the default Live Cube, the name given to the immersive environment we'll be working in. If you're wondering why the view looks so yellow, there's a good reason. You are actually witnessing a sunset in our Live Cube. This may not be the best time of day to start work on our tropical resort, so let's fix this right now. From the main sidebar menu on the left, we select Sun and Atmosphere Settings. In the sidebar submenu, note the time of day is 4:59 on March 29. Let's change the time of day. That's better. There's more we could tinker with here, but we need to move on. Before we do, here's a quick tip. To toggle the sidebar menu on and off, click the Tab key. This is handy when you want to maximize the display of your project. Next, we need to take a few moments to understand some rudimentary view navigation controls. At the bottom of the screen, you'll see the current mode is fly-through. When you mouse click and move the pointer, it is as if you are swiveling your head up, down, left, and right. Clicking the center button, usually the wheel on the mouse, changes to orbit mode. Now the view's contents rotates around the center of the view. You can also use the Alt key plus left mouse button to do the same thing. You can use the arrow keys on your keyboard to move left, right, in, and out. You can also zoom in and out using the mouse wheel. Knowing these few navigation moves will have you zipping around in the Live Cube in no time. Back to the job at hand, creating our tropical resort. Rolling the mouse wheel back gives us perspective of just how large the Live Cube is. Holding down the Shift key as you roll the mouse wheel speeds up navigation so you can travel great distances across the terrain. This is a large area, but does not appear to be very tropical or island-like. Not quite what we're looking for in our tropical getaway. Let's change the terrain. Returning to the main sidebar menu, we select Terrain and Ocean, then load terrain. There are several terrain types to choose from. For our scenario, we select the islands terrain. You're probably asking yourself at this point, where's the water? Good question. When you select islands, the ocean is temporarily deactivated, and for good reason. Right now, our hotel is actually sitting on the ocean seabed. This is the default location of all models that originate from an application such as MicroStation. It is nothing special, it's just the bottom dead center of the Live Cube. Imagine having to move the hotel model around while underwater. We can all agree that having the ocean temporarily turned off is a good idea. It is now time to move our hotel to somewhere less wet. For instance, that island over there. Having the water turned off will make this move much easier. Before we can move the hotel from its watery grave, we need to unlock it from the sea bottom. This is done by turning off the hotel's Lock Transform option. Using the selection tool from the sidebar menu, we double-click the hotel to select it. Then, we simply turn off the Lock Transform option. The hotel is now unhooked from the terrain and ready for transport. We move the hotel to the island on the right by using the Move Gizmo. Yes, that's what it's called. It is one of three gizmos that help orient and scale models in the Live Cube. We haven't activated the water yet, but it's pretty obvious there's a nice little cove on the south side of the island. So let's move the hotel to a position where we can take full advantage of that cove view. With our hotel safely on dry land, time to turn on the ocean. Returning to Terrain and Ocean again, we click Ocean Settings. and simply click Activate. That's much better. Now we can see the sand around the island. Let's take a closer look at the hotel. There seems to be a bit of a problem with the hotel's position. Do you see the air under the hotel and how part of it is overrun with island grass? This indicates the ground at the location where we place the hotel is uneven. This site needs some improvement, so our building will sit level, an important consideration for our guests. Visiting terrain and ocean again, we grab our shovel, officially known as the Sculpt Terrain Tool. We have four shovel functions: fill, dig, flatten, and stitch. What we need here is obviously flatten. Here's a tip. Because we want our hotel to sit on a perfectly flat surface from edge to edge, select a brush size just large enough to overlap the narrow side of the hotel object. 65 or so meters will work here. A quick swipe under the building does the trick. We may not get it right on the first pass, so we'll use the Undo tool on the sidebar menu and give it another go. At this point, we've saved our hotel from drowning and have found it a nice home with a lovely view of the cove. There's still a lot to do. In the next video, we'll begin the transformation of our barren island into the tropical paradise we want by adding trees and other vegetation. If you like what you've seen so far, hit the like button. If you want to see more Luminar Tea and other Bentley product videos, hit the subscribe button. And don't forget, if you want to know when we post new content, click the bell icon. See you next time.